No one can get away from junk. There are well over 1,000 satellites orbiting Earth, including the International Space Station. But there's a lot of dangerous space debris whizzing around up there as well, and that debris could be devastating, as we saw in the movie Gravity.
Yes.
We need to get the hell out of here.
Some help there, man.
No, don't wait for us. Man down. Man down.
That, of course, isn't a documentary, but space junk is real and it's a growing problem, with scientists working hard to do something about it. For more, let's welcome Fred Watson from the Australian Astronomical Observatory. Hi. So when we're talking about space debris, how big are these pieces of junk?
They start off like flecks of paint and they end up... The biggest one is 10 metres across. It's a European environmental satellite that is now space junk. Weighs 8.5 tonnes.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, so, you know, it's the full range. There's about 170 million bits of space debris, smaller than a centimetre.
Wow.
And the problem with it is that these things are travelling at such enormous speeds. So their collision speeds are 10, 11, 12 kilometres per second.
A second?
You know, yeah. So that's why it's dangerous.
Goodness.
Wow. The British astronaut Tim...
That's right.
What's his surname?
Peake.
Photographed damage on a space station window. What happened there?
So that was a fleck of paint. So there's a tiny little splinter out of the cupola window on the space station, which is quite new, actually, that part of the station. And, yeah, he had a look at it, and sure enough, there's this fleck of paint... sized debris chunk out of the window.
That is just so incredibly cool. Yeah. So now you've got a plan. This sounds like something out of another science fiction movie. There is a plan to actually capture the space junk.
There are many plans, and I have to say they're not mine. We astronomers, we just watch in awe as these guys do their thing. But what's made the news this week is a project by the University of Surrey in the UK, who are proposing next year to launch a satellite with the incredible name of Remove Debris. Who thinks of these things? Remove Debris.
Scientists have never been the greatest marketers in the world.
Why don't they change it to Junky McJunkface or something?
Yeah, they probably will.
How do they actually do it, though?
Well, nobody knows. That's the problem. So this Remove Debris is an experiment. It carries on board some little... what are called CubeSats. They're things this size. They chuck one out and then they try and get it back to you know, demonstrate that you can remove space junk.
But I mean, are they going to blow the junk up, or are they going to catch it in giant nets?
Yeah, actually a giant net is one of them.
Really?
Well done, Otto. You should be working for these guys.
I'm going to go with magnets.
But, the problem is these things are made of non-ferrous metal, so magnets don't do a lot. So there's a harpoon, there is a net, and there is basically a kind of solar sail which will act like a giant...
Oh my God.
That's the sail, yeah. So what you want to do is shift the orbit of the spacecraft so that it actually descends into the atmosphere, and then it burns up, it's harmless, and it's gone.
We need to know what happens as well. I mean, if we leave all this space junk out there, I mean, it's not just an aesthetic thing. We don't just need to clean up space so it looks better, but it can actually be very dangerous having all this debris flying about, yeah?
Well, the first thing is we rely every day, almost every second of our lives, we rely on the space industry with communications, surveillance, the whole gig. So space is very important, and exactly as you said, if you don't clean up the junk, what you get is this kind of domino effect. Basically, one spacecraft runs into another. That creates gazillions of bits of debris. Those bits of debris run into something else, and it becomes, you know, potentially a situation where we might lose a generation of access to space.
Could I be hit by a piece of junk?
On the way up, you could. Yes, you could, because you're going through this cloud. I mean, it's wrong to imagine it as a cloud of stuff where you can see it, but there is enough material there that it's quite dangerous.
What is it about humans that we leave junk around? You know, not only do we pollute our world, we pollute our space.
It's because it's been unregulated over all, you know, the 60-odd years of the space age. Nobody's thought, oh, yes, we should do something about this, until now. Mm-hmm. And, in fact, the legislation is improving. So the French, for example, have just enacted a law that says you can only put a spacecraft up there for 25 years. It's got to have a mechanism to bring it back down again so it doesn't turn into space junk.
What if one of these big pieces of space junk falls to Earth? Do we all need stack hats?
You'd need a good one too.
Yeah.
In fact, very few of them do. Okay. And that's because most of them are small enough that they hit the atmosphere at 8 kilometres per second.
It burns up.
And it just burns up like that. But something as big as that Envisat, the 8-tonne one, a lot of that would come down. The good thing is most of the Earth's surface is covered in ocean,
yeah.
So there's a good chance it will land usually in the Pacific. That's where they tend to fall.
Fred Watson, always good talking to you. Thanks so much for joining us.